trading newsletters.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another exciting edition of the Power Trading Hour with me, your humble, lovable, and squeezably soft host.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
Well, I thought we would probably stumble up for a while, but we rocketed up after the numbers came out at 8:30 for unemployment. I have a feeling that a lot of people were just expecting the end of the world in short, and that's exactly what they got. They got the messy short end of the stick as the market went higher. We're almost 100 points higher on the S&P. Dow's up about 900 points, 255 for the NASDAQ. Russell up 50, and crude oil on the loser side. Down $1.90. So as we go through the day, we're going to look at it. I sold my first position of the ones that I bought at the lows, mostly because in this kind of, well, we'll have them on today, I think, right? This is Thursday, right? All day? I think so. Maybe he did. Maybe he forgot about it. Normally he emails me. Oh, we've got our charts. Anyway, Tim Ord will be on here in the next segment. He's got a couple of charts, so we'll go through that with him. And we'll find out a lot of other stuff going on. But it is going to be continually choppy, although we will have, yes, he will call. I've got a nervous Nancy for an engineer today. He calls pretty much every time. He bothered to send me some charts, so I assume he's going to call. So we'll talk to him today. But one of the things I was going to say about is that there was a theory that Tim Ord had, and he kind of loosely defined it. I kind of nailed him down to it in the, I don't know, around 2004 or five, and that is kind of the three bears. Sometimes volume's too hot. Sometimes it's just right, and sometimes it's too cold. And if it's just right, you can go on for a very long time. Sometimes the bulb that burns twice as bright only burns half as long. So if you sit on a bunch of real fast profits, generally you're going to pull back and you're going to consolidate if it continues to go higher. So you can always pull back. Anyway, we'll look at that trade. And we'll be getting out of it today before the end of the day in the Tech Insider. What was going to be kind of a long-term trade gave us all the money we wanted almost instantly. And rats, I hate that when it happens. So we'll talk about that probably after with Tim. And I'll think what else we have. Well, we got a lot of charts that say we're fairly close to rather major resistance. We'll look at a couple of those charts after talking with Tim. And I'm trying to think, if we have enough time in this segment, we'll get to it. But that's it. A lot of short covering. Yes, I suspect a lot of people went short last night after Bernie started talking about torpedoing the deal. That kind of got the ball rolling a little bit. And then we had just a lot of people just assuming it was going to be 10 or 20 million. I don't know what they thought. I had to figure that everybody knew that the question wasn't whether or not we were going to have lots of unemployed. It's how fast do they get back to work? And that is, I think, the single driving question for the market as we go forward. And what else do we have? We've got a little history. We'll get that done and see what else we have time for.
Just a little bit of history repeating.
On this day in 1999, the first email virus to cause widespread damage and one of the fastest spreading viruses in history, the Melissa virus, was released into the wild on an early Friday morning. Within 3 days, would infect 100,000 and maybe 250,000 computers around the world. While the virus did not directly cause any damage, the sheer volume of email that it generated crashed many corporate Microsoft email servers. And, of course, what it did was go and find the first 50 people in your email list and email them, too. So one became 50. The gentleman that wrote the virus really never got in trouble. He lived in Sweden somewhere. The real genius was this guy named David Lee Smith, who was a resident of Florida, who went on the lam and was later caught up in New Jersey, hiding out with his brother, I think. He got it started when the users took the bait, downloading the document, opening it up with Microsoft Word. A virus was unleashed on their computers, and they caught him fairly quickly. He did get sentenced, and then, of course, you never know the future, but 9/11 came along, and suddenly they were looking for anybody that knew how to get in to ISIS's and all the other people that were doing us ill. It's unclear when he got out of jail. No one knows what's happened to him since. Certainly his name's been changed. But no one knows whether he's alive, but he was certain. He was sentenced to 20 months, may have done like half of that, and then vanished off the face of the earth. He may not have been a good virus writer, but he was a great engineer at delivering the payload. I suspect that some three-letter government agency he's probably still working for them, but not a hair or hide of a clue of what happened to this dude after then. And of course, you have to kind of almost think that why it didn't really cause any real damage and it was over in a matter of a day or two. What it did start was a virus protection industry that I don't think is very much different than the guy that wanders by in New Jersey and goes, be a shame if someone broke your windows, sir. In fact, a lot of these folks find out that the virus writers and the people that write the virus cures and the virus scanners may be the exact same people in Russia or the Ukraine or a lot of different East Bloc countries that were once under the Soviet Union's thumb. Interesting. And I kind of, for a virus of a different kind, where we mostly talk about the corona one today, I thought it was a very interesting look back. As we said, it just seems like probably we're running out a little steam. The question on how much higher we go probably depend a lot more on whether or not people keep shorting the close of the day. We'll see how this goes. But normally, I thought that the close yesterday was probably going to be a little bearish, but all it meant was those folks had to cover today. We'll be back after this.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN is launching an open house for our Tiger's Den. For a limited time, you can get a 30-day free trial to the Tiger's Den. Just enter promo code OPEN at checkout and pay nothing for 30 days while you try out your Tiger's Den membership as part of our open house. With market volatility at an all-time high and people all over the world working from home if possible, TFNN is hosting an open house in our Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is an interactive chat room that runs all day where other Tigers and Tigresses discuss trading ideas with the hosts and members, along with charts and current market news, as well as live access to the charts the hosts use during their programs. Join us for the Tiger's Den Open House. Begin your den membership today by just entering OPEN at checkout and pay nothing while you try things out for 30 days. For all the details and to start your den membership today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the TFNN Tiger's Den Open House taking place now. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we want to welcome Tim Ord to the line. When we had him on just a scant few weeks ago, none of this, I think, was more than kind of just maybe an idea. Now we've got a reality, and we've got a couple of charts. How you doing today, Tim?
Good. Thanks for having me on.
Glad to have
you. Actually, the first, we can start on the charts if you want. We got the first chart is the SPX in a 10-year treasury, and it's the ratio. And this chart goes back to looks like 2006, I think.
Mm-hmm.
My eyesight's not that good, but anyhow, it goes back a bunch of years. And what I did was take the RSI of the SPX 10-year treasuries, and every time the RSI got below 20. Your lease had some sort of exhaustion move to the downside. And the red vertical lines that go all the way through the chart are those times when that happened. And if you notice, it all of them came at some sort of exhaustion low. And we just had this happen here just a few days ago, right close to the bottom. So that recent exhaustion moved to the downside. And there's another chart all the way to the bottom. It's kind of a little hard to see, but that's the McCollum oscillator, the traditional method. And when the McCollum oscillator gets down below 400, which is pretty rare, we just did it here a few days ago, right at the lows. And the last three times it happened in 2008, 2010, and 2011, and all of them at least stopped at a decline, and the market kind of just flipped sideways. I'm thinking we reached some sort of a exhaustion move to the downside, and what happens next? It depends. If we rally actually pretty strongly, then we could be like the 2018 bottom, you know, December 2018 bottom, but I don't think we're doing that. We're not really coming off the lows that strongly. I mean, we're going up decently. So we'll see how, you know, how the rally continues. If we do at least a 6%, 61.8% retracement of the previous decline, which is a long ways up from here, then that opens the door for a V bottom. But my view is we're probably going to stop around the 38% retracement, which is eyeballing it here. It looks like about 265 on the SPY. So we'll see. We've been up 3 days in a row so far. And in my view here, I bet tomorrow's be an up day too. So we'll have to wait and see. But we can jump to the next chart too if you want, if you got questions.
Go right ahead.
Okay. This is, we looked at McCall and Oscar hitting below 400, which is pretty rare. And this next chart is a summation index, the McCall and summation index. And the last time we hit 1257 on March 24th, minus 1257 on March 24th. And the previous times we got below 1200 was September of 1998, and the market went up for about a month. And again in July of 2008, and also December of 2008. And both those times, the market bounced for about 30 days. So even though there's not a lot of occurrences, we'll at least reach some sort of a bottom here. And it looks like we'll probably bounce, in my opinion, for 30 days. So probably late March, somewhere in that time frame, that bounce may be done. And it depends on how far the market rallies up to determine what the next move will be. If the market's still in this vicinity where we are right now or close to it, then that opens the door to the downside quite a bit, because the market was unable to even rally back to 38.2% retracement. That would imply this decline's halfway done. But if we do get managed up to around, say, 50, maybe even a 60% retracement, then probably the worst-case scenario is maybe a test of the lows we had Monday or something like that. So we're kind of watching what's going on. So, but at least on a short-term basis, it does appear the worst is over. And how the market responds over the next approximately 30 days will tell you what to expect next. So interesting market. So not sure how strong this rally is going to be. But if you're looking internally, you know, the advanced clients actually have been decent. Even decent today, it's about close to 10 to 1 to the upside. And McCall and Oscar is going to go higher today than yesterday, suggesting that the market could be up again tomorrow. So if you get 4 days up in a row, there's 82% chance the market will be higher within 5 days. So if we get fourth day up tomorrow, that suggests the rally's still not done. So
that's kind of the that's kind of the what is it, the magazine thing, where they have the 4 or 5 days up in, I'm just trying to remember what the name of the Investors Daily. Is that what it is? Investor? I'll think of it.
Actually, I don't quite remember. I just, you get statistics, you know, I just Google it. So
yeah,
that's where I get my statistics. Up 4 days in a row, what's the percentage of the market will be higher? 5 days. And they come out with statistics for that. So, if tomorrow's up, then
Investors.
You know, even though
Investors Business Daily. I think they're the one that started that 4 or 5 days up thing. That was kind of interesting. I wanted to get one thing before we go to the break here in about a minute and a half. And you were talking about retracements in the SPY. SPY.
Right.
Are you talking about a retracement all the way from the February 19th high, 339, back down to this 218? Or
yeah.
Is it?
Yeah, I'm talking about that whole retracement. So, you know, we're nearing the 38% retracement right now. You know, tomorrow we could hit that 38% retracement.
So that'd be 260. Yeah, it'd be 264 41 is the 382, 50% is 278, and a 618 looks like 292.
Yeah, yeah, that's pretty much what close to what I have. I can't quite read the numbers, but that's in the vicinity where they are. And so it's pretty important how, and I think we got a month, you know, according to these other indicators, that the market may just flub around here. And so I'd say if we do get to 61.8% retracement, then I think the worst case scenario is just a test of, you know, Monday's low.
Okay.
And it could set up a double bottom. So
well, we're going to go to the break here. When we come back, we've got a phone call, and we're going to have somebody ask us a question. Thanks, Tim. We'll be back on in just a minute with Tim and Dave from Framingham, Massachusetts.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we've got Tim Ord on the line of the Ord-Oracle.com. He's one of the, as I said in the newsletter earlier this week, generally, I'm the son of many fathers in trading, and certainly Tim Ord was one of those, certainly in my early days. We've got Dave from Framingham, Massachusetts on the line. How are you doing today, Dave?
Hi, thank you for taking my call.
Go right ahead.
Yeah, hi, Tim, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here, Phil. You have a question?
Tim, do you see the 3,300 on the S&P? There's a gap there. I don't know why gaps get filled, but do you see that gap getting filled before we go back down?
At 300?
At 3,300 on the S&P, SPX.
On the SPYs, or looking at the SPYs here.
SPX, there's a gap there at 33.
That's quite a ways up. I mean, it could. I mean, that's approximately around the 61.8% retracement. Don't know the market will get that far higher here, but, you know, the way things are going right now, at least Advanced Klein or the McCollum Osclear is showing strength here. Can we, you know, push up there? Put it this way, if we're not up there by late April, we're probably not going to get there. So,
yeah, that's
but if we
I'm
do
saying.
Get there, that would be a good area to watch how the volume is tested on that gap. But not sure, you know, just purely to say, you know, most gaps do get filled at some point. But, you know, we could, I'm not sure. It's too early to say. Yeah, we're too far away.
Yeah. Do you see this S&P as a V-shape? It's turning into a V-shape here.
Yeah. You know, I like back at that December 2018 low, we got actually long before that low actually happened, but we kept it because it turned out to be a V. Just everything remained McCollum Osclear would just remain strong. So it's sort of important, you know, determine if this is going to be a V or not, as long as McCollum Osclear keeps moving higher every day. And so far it has the last 3 days, and today will be 4 days. So McCollum Osclear, in my opinion, will be kind of the key if we have a V bottom or not, especially if you get an oversold deal, McCollum Osclear hit minus 400. If you go up to like plus 300 on a McCollum Osclear, that would say the bottom's in, because if you get a range, that big of a range from a very negative number to a very high number, that would suggest that real internal strength in the market. And when we go back down for a test of a low, that would probably not be the case if McCollum Osclear managed to get over 300.
Yeah, I mean, this was a severe drop, and the way it came down, no one expected it, but what says that we can't go right back up and make a V-shape, a sharp rise up, back up to that top, double top, make
right.
it a double top.
The only thing bad about that V bottom here is I do quite a bit of work with the trend, and the trend really didn't blow out at the bottoms. On this particular bottom we're having right now, the trend, as a matter of fact, at that low, the trend barely, the 10-day trend didn't even get over one at the March 23rd low. And that's usually kind of dangerous for intermediate term. If you go back and look in history, like all the major bottoms, like 2008, 1998, 2010, 2011, even the 2018 bottoms, the 10-day trend, he got up to 1.5 or even higher. And this one did not. And so intermediate term, that could be a bearish sign. So I'm kind of not convinced this is going to be a V bottom because the 10-day trend didn't get above 1.5. So that suggests the market may go up here, hold up for the next month. But my opinion, we're at least going to come back down, test the March 23rd low, and possibly even break that low. So that's how I'm seeing it, because we did not get the extreme panic readings where everybody kind of just threw in the towel, I guess you might say.
For those folks that haven't followed you, Tim, you kind of have a much longer time frame than most traders probably have. So when you're talking about it tests the bottom, you're probably not talking about testing it tomorrow, but a month or 2 months or maybe 3 months down the line.
Yeah, I'm thinking here we're going to stabilize possibly for the next 30 days to the upside, and whatever the market does, it creates a trading range, or we actually keep going up. But I don't think the final bottom's in, because the 10-day trend at this last low we had on Monday didn't have a blowout reading of a 10-day average of around at least 1.5. All major other bottoms were at least that, if not higher. So we may go up for a month, but at some point, when it could be 2 months away, it could be 3 months away, we'll at least come back down and visit this low, if not break it. So, yeah, you're right. We're not
okay.
I think we're okay for the next 30 days. After that, I don't know.
Okay. So, I'm just thinking by the end of April, we should be up making a double top.
maybe not that quick. I was going to say, I'm looking at the New York McClellan summation index, and when you're giving the numbers for your sum index, you're talking about just the S&P stocks, right? Negative 400?
That was a NYSE McClellan oscillator.
Okay. Just curious, because the numbers, depending on how you do it, are very different. I'm showing the one that I have right now, which is negative 1,900. But both the 5 and 10% inputs to the New York summation index, which has, what, about 2,800 stocks or something? Both of those have turned up the last 2 days, and we have a pretty good advanced decline line today. So this is going to be third day up, and at some point, that's going to turn up. That's going to be bullish for a while unless that starts declining, right?
Right, yeah. As long as McCall and Oscar remains above zero, the summation index will be heading higher.
Yeah, so that's like you said, at least some kind of short-term thing until we get some kind of top in the summation index or it goes flat or sideways or something like that. And then probably at that point start thinking about possible downsides in the market. If we don't, everybody gets back to work and it's like it never happened, one thing. If something else comes out of the blue or this somehow gets worse than a lot of people thought, then you may get that one more retest. So,
yeah.
Or, that's
or,
pretty good.
You know, the trouble is you don't want this to be like a 2008.
Yeah.
You know, and it could. But, you know, we had a steep decline in a very short period of time, so we did reach some sort of exhaustion move. The only thing bad about this exhaustion move to the downside, the trend didn't really get high.
The only thing I noticed was that we had three massive, huge, short days in the put-call ratio. And this is last one on Monday was the last huge day. I want to thank you for calling in today, Tim. Thanks for the caller, Dave. And we'll be back in just a few minutes. Catch Tim at the ord-oracle.com. And thanks for everybody chiming in today. We'll be back in a minute.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foresight Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And yeah, it's we talked about this one in the den a little earlier. QGen, QGEN is the symbol. These folks have started shipping a test that runs on an automated machine, gives you an answer on 20 different corona type viruses within an hour. And of course, they've kind of modified how long it takes to get a lot of this stuff through. But I thought it was interesting. I figured since they were on the TV talking that they'd have a spike high as they did today, $42.41. You know what? We're probably getting out of the worst part of it seasonally because of the weather, at least in the United States. These are the kind of stocks to always keep an eye on. If we get back into the winter and it's still an issue, you may want to keep an eye on it. Fairly interesting. The big problem I continue to have, and we brought it up in the Tiger's Den today earlier, is you don't know, and we still don't have any real good numbers on false positive and false negatives for the test. So we don't know. Did see a lot of people in artificial intelligence, machine learning, working on figuring out by reading x-rays whether or not you've got it, which is very interesting. And so far, I think they've got a couple thousand x-ray exemplars, and their machine learning vision version of it is about 98% correct in identifying it just from the x-rays, which I thought was kind of interesting. I don't know how far that is going to go, but x-rays probably a little bit more invasive than these tests that take all of about a minute to do and an hour to get the results for. But those things can be moved out and widely deployed a little bit. As a special request, we can play it. And that is, can't we just have a nice day today? Enough for the negative waves, the stock market's up. Maybe things are getting just a little bit brighter. So we had a special request of Professor Mad Dog from Kelly's Heroes.
Don't you knock it off with them negative waves. Why don't you dig how beautiful it is out here? Why don't you say something righteous and hopeful for a change?
Always with the negative waves, Moriarty. Always with the negative waves.
Yeah, I love that movie, but more than anything, I like that. Just can we have some... Can we have a nice day? Just one, please. Okay. What else do we have going on out here? I wanted to get to some others. For the stocks that I'm watching that I think are important, Apple getting back over and holding $250 was something that I thought was going to be important today. We're at 253. I want to watch how that closes. The reason is that we are coming in to a bunch of these days where you had pretty heavy downdrafts. On the 16th, it was 80 million shares to the downside. So far, we're doing about 40. So I'm, you know, in the short term, could we pull back just a little bit and keep moving higher? I think the answer is yes. I'm not so sure that we're going to have anything more than a lot of back and fill. One of the other things I'd like to think about over the next few days is if we're going to have an impulse wave, one that just goes straight up and then burns out, or if we're going to have something more that after the first couple of steps here that we kind of stumble back a little bit, stumble forward a couple of steps, stumble back one. To me, the idea that we just go straight up, probably a little terrifying, actually. In the fact that if we do we just roll over and then that's it? And we go to 1929. I'd like to see this thing kind of build on a wall of worry instead of just instantly discount everything that has come on before. The idea that we could go a month and continue stumbling higher is not foreign. But at the same time, I was talking to Tim about what numbers he was using. We were showing the SPYs and other retracements on those. Let me get this back up here. But yeah, I mean, for what he's talking about, that would be the 618, which would negate everything below the what we did. You have to get to 292 on the SPYs. And that's just figuring if you can go back and recapture two-thirds of all the losses, then maybe it wasn't what everybody thought it was at the lows. This is going to be a lot more complicated. I've talked about two stories. And the first story on stocks that bounce are that they highly overshorted, and everybody is going to short them at the end of every day and cover the next day, or they're going to short them through the day and cover at the close. But the idea is that they're not going to be able to stay very short for very long as the market kind of stumbles back up. Now, the big thing is when people quit shorting. That's generally what happened at the very last week of February and why the destruction was so heavy. We didn't have that many shorts. Every time someone shorted in February, they got their teeth kicked in. So there was almost nobody short. I tried to actually get a couple of the things, and there just wasn't much in the way of getting it. We were talking also about the first stock that I've sold now from buying off the lows, and that was Avalara. I bought it at, 63, and we sold it today. I don't have a quote right now. Let me take a look here. Okay, 97.51, but it's got about 500,000 shares. You came down with 1.5 million shares on the 9th. 1.5 million shares on the 12th. So, you know, we've had a fairly good bounce. You get $17 in a handful of days on a $63 stock. The question is, at what point are you not getting a little piggy? To me, the stocks that always go up that fast tend to recover. So I think maybe I'll be able to buy this back in the $70 range, maybe 69. But it was one that I wanted to actually buy and have wanted to buy for a long time. We talked about this on the Tech Insider with Tom O'Brien about new IPOs. And the thing just never, ever gave a good technical indication of where to buy. One of the other ones that I loved was Workday, and I missed it this time. It was just too violent at the lows. But it certainly is the same kind of thing. I'd love to buy this one back at about 130 if I get that lucky. I don't know. This thing was a monster to $202, almost split in half. You got to figure you're going to have some kind of consolidation. But those are two stocks that I really liked. I didn't get Workday. But going forward, both of them should be fine. Avalara, of course, basically the cloud service for taxes, and Workday, kind of the paychecks and the back office for many companies on the cloud. But both cloud-based services that do very well. Workday, I loved, and I talked about it when it came out, too. I missed most of the move higher on it, mostly because, again, it never gave a good technical signal to buy. But both of these are monsters. Hopefully they'll do well in the future. We'll be back in a market. Oh, Otis, stumbling around, the drunk.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And I wanted to look at Microsoft before we left as one of the strongest in the tech sectors. Up today, not a lot of juice, 37 million shares compared to the down day of 87 million shares, 88. That's why I suspect why everybody thinks this is going to rocket off. We're probably going to go sideways for a little while, maybe even a little bit of a pullback. I don't know on Microsoft. It may continue as everybody picks it as the strongest horse in the field. But I think the volumes are light enough today to suggest that maybe we just go sideways for a handful of days. Maybe we pull back. Maybe we just consolidate these gains a little bit. But I continue to think that maybe the easiest of the money is over. And now they're going to ask for a little bit of hard work from us traders. As I said, the money just doesn't fall out of the disk drive, does it? I asked that to one guy who told me that his trading system just made money beyond all scale. I said, can I just put a little jar down there and watch the money fall out right out of the disk drive into my jar right there? Just It could be just 1 ounce coins of gold. That's fine. We'll just let them fall out into the jar, and I'll collect them at the end of the day. That's no good. We all know that it's not that easy ever. It is a chaotic market. As we look at what's going on today, of course, over 10 billion shares, so the volume did shrink a little bit throughout, at least today. The dollar index kind of, you know, taking the hit down a buck 46 today. It is back under 100 at $99.53. And, of course, when we look at the rest of it, we got a lot of moving pieces out here. Don't expect that it's going to be always as easy as the last couple of days, just to go long and close our eyes. In the meantime, sell when you can, not when you have to, and we will see you here tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time.